Hey, it's your average consumer. I just want to let you guys know that this channel was made with the average consumer in mind. All right, let's get to another tech video. Hey, what's going on, guys? It's your average consumer. Today, I'm going to be reviewing the Beats by Dre Studios. All right, let's not waste any time. Let's get right into it.
All right, guys, so here we have the Beats Studios, and here we have the traveling case that come with it. Now, the traveling case is pretty nice. It's a hard shell case, as you can see, and it's pretty good for protection and travel. It's a little on the large side, but you know, the headphones are on the large side as well, so can't really fault them for that. But you know, these are good. I like that it comes with the little clip here so that you can just like attach it to your book bag or something like that. And it just makes traveling with the Beats a lot easier if you don't want it around your neck. Alright, so now on to the Beats Studios. These are a really nice pair of headphones, and they really do feel like a high quality item. When you have these, when you see these in person, you can tell that it's made of some decent material and that it's just some pretty decent quality as far as the build is concerned. You can see the little chrome finish here, and the top has a really nice padding up for the headband. So this really does feel like a high quality item, and it does feel durable. It seems like it can last. You can bend it pretty well without it snapping. A lot of people are concerned about snapping the headbands of the Beats. I wouldn't bring these out as far as the Street by 50, but these do seem to be some pretty decent quality. It's really, of course, it's stylish. People love the way the Beats look. I like the way it looks. These, personally, though, the Studios themselves, they're a little on the bigger side to me. I personally don't really like how big they are. My favorite pair of headphones by Beats are the Beats Wireless, which are a tad bigger than the Solo HDs. And in comparison to them, you can see how big the cups are. You can see how long the cups here and compared to the wireless right here. So you got quite some size on these headphones, but they do their job and as far as delivering on sound quality. But it's just, my only gripe would be the size of them. And as far as, you know, gripes or whatever, the only other gripe would be the fact that these headphones do not work if you don't have the little switch on. And I would have liked if the switch would just turn on noise canceling, but it's to turn on the headphones themselves. If you don't have it on, the headphones won't work. If the battery dies, the headphones won't work. So that's really not a good thing for these headphones. A lot of headphones, you just want to be able to plug it in and go and not have to worry about battery life. But these, unfortunately, do not function without the battery. So that's definitely something to keep in mind. I always happen to forget that the switch is on, and it always makes me worry that I'm draining the life out of the battery that's inside there. But so far, to be honest, it's every time I've done that, the battery is still going. I haven't had to change it yet. So obviously it's not using too much battery, but it's just a little problem when you have to sit there and worry about how much battery you have left without really knowing what's going on with that. But those are like the only real gripes I have with the Studios as far as the way it looks and how it functions. When it comes to sound quality now, the Beats Studios deliver on some great sound quality. Like, it's really what you would expect from a $300 pair of headphones. If you're a bass lover, these really will do the trick for you. They deliver with a lot of bass, and it does a really good job isolating sounds on the outside with noise canceling feature, and it really helps you to just focus on the music and really just tune out everything else and really just listen to the music. So it sounds great if you're into things like hip hop and dubstep, things with a lot of bass. These will definitely do a great thing for you by canceling everything out and just let the bass blast in your ears. So if you're not really looking for bass heavy headphones, maybe this might not be what you want, because these really do have a lot of bass. Some people have complained that the bass drowns out all the other sounds, like it makes the music not sound as good. I don't think that. I think the music sounds wonderful with these. So even with the bass or not, these sound really great to me and to the type of music I listen to, which is like, you know, hip hop and, you know, R&B, stuff like that. So I really think this does deliver on the whole good sound quality thing. My only problem with the sound though would be if you increase the volume too high, people will definitely hear you and people will definitely hear your music. I am going to have a sound leak test that shows you just how much the sound leaks. At comfortable volumes, I was told that people can hear my music and pretty clearly at that. They could hear lyrics and everything. So that's not even at a loud volume. That's just at a comfortable volume. So that's definitely something to keep in mind. If you don't want to, if you're going to be somewhere where there's going to be a lot of people and you don't want to disturb them, then maybe these might not be the ones for you because they do leak a lot. It's really bad, but the sound still sounds great to you, but it'll probably sound pretty great to other people too by who are around you. So overall, guys, that's my review for the Beats Studios. They're a really great pair of headphones and they offer some really great sound quality. Now, I know there are people who will say that you can get better for less, but it goes a little bit beyond just like sound quality and stuff like that. It's also really stylish, and if you like the Beats brand, I say go for it. Why not? So just something to keep in mind. My only gripes with these were the fact that they do leak a lot, and I don't like the fact that with these off, you won't be able to listen to music. So if you have like a dead battery or you just have the switch off, you won't be able to listen to music. You can't just plug and play. So that's just a little problem for me. And it's also just a little inconvenient when you forget to turn off the switch and then it kills your battery. So that's something also to keep in mind. Also, these are a bit on the bigger side. So make sure when you're about to purchase these, you look for a demo version, see if you're okay with the size. And if you're okay with that, I say go for it. The sound quality is great. It does a really good job at isolating sounds from the outside, so you really can just focus on the headphones themselves. And pretty much that's all there is to the Beats Studios, guys. If you're interested, I say go for it. Just keep those things, little things I said in mind. And that's about it, guys. So thanks for watching. This is Your Average Consumer. Please feel free to rate, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. All right, peace.